Oh, this is Bobby at Copelty VDPN with a functionality pro video for main board for Visio M421VT. Lately we have made several such videos, and this is just another one of them. This board is about to go to a customer who bought one on eBay. I just turned it on and it's currently still flashing the white sign that normally sits in the edge of the TV. We just pulled the board out so that it's more easily accessible this way. It's currently flashing initializing. This is the board. I'm showing a few unique markings on it so that the customer knows that the board that they will be looking at will be that exact same board. This is fairly unique. The corner here of the EEPROM that is colored in bluish whatever small dot. And I'm going to be making a few comments that can also be found in other videos of ours about the same board, in fact very recent ones. This is today's date, 15th of October, and this unit, as I have mentioned in many of our videos, is E422VA, which is being powered by the backlight on it is with CCFL lamps. Those wires are from the inverter that is on the power board, which is encapsulated behind this so that we don't short something. But this is the transformers for the backlight inverter. M421VT, on the other hand, is an LED TV. And this is just one difference between them. They use, however, very, very, very similar front panels. In the meantime, this started and we have the Visio front sign, and it's going to be hanging here for a minute or two, and the reason for that is that E422VA does not have the Bluetooth module that M421VT does. There is a wire that goes out of here into a Bluetooth module, which is responsible for connecting to the wireless keyboard via Bluetooth. Right now that board is searching here and not finding anything, and that's why it keeps on searching. But in case it doesn't find anything, it will just continue without the Bluetooth remote functionality. It is just something that delays it here at the startup. That is another difference so far too. The screen, the backlight on the TV is different, and the main boards, even though they look very much alike, the E422VA does not have that connector. But other than that, the two boards at first glance look actually exactly alike. The differences are very minor, but there are some, like this one. There's also another one on the output signal is slightly different on the two. And the result of that is that line that you see here, which is moving down, and there's another one that is showing up. This is not going to be showing on an actual M421VT, and I've covered that many, many times in our videos. The purpose of this video is to show customer that this board does not have any of the most common problems for those boards, which are: number one, TV doesn't power on at all. Number two, it powers on, but the HDMI is not working. HDMI is clearly working. This is our media player, currently connected to HDMI 1. Apparently it is reading signal. So do the other HDMIs. Do not be worried about those two lines. They are, because we are testing board for M421VT on E422VA. The opposite is also possible for those who care to test. But this is pretty much what we wanted to show. This board is tested and is functional, and it is going to be sent in this exact form without any other changes. Again, this is today's date. Thank you.